Hello, my name is Ben and I'm a rendering engineer. If it's your first time here, I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. In today's video, we're going to be doing this erosion effect. So the setup for the shader is very simple. All we have up here is some blending and we also have texture sampling and we're just outputting the texture right now. So the first thing we want to do is duplicate all the texture stuff because when it comes to masking, we need a mask texture. So let's go ahead and make that. The UVs are a float 2. I'm going to change them to a float 4. And then here I'm going to do .xy. XY will be the first texture. And ZW will be the second texture. So for the sampling, we need XY. And we can save this off and it should be okay. And now we have two textures that we can work with. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add a mask texture. We'll just use this black and white, and we'll use probably the red channel to do all of the masking. To do a simple mask, let's duplicate this color here. We'll call it mask. Instead of main text, we need to use mask text. And of course, we also need to update the transform text to use mask text here so that we're using the proper tiling and offset values. Instead of XY, we're going to use ZW. And we're going to reconstruct this real quick. We'll do a fixed 4. We'll print out the color, RGB, or display the color, RGB. For the alpha, we need to use mask.r. Let's just do that. So it looks like it worked. And let's just check the tiling real quick. Yeah, so I can tile this value. And this one will tile the B. Cool. Now, we've lost the alpha for the B, so let's add that back. That's color.a. We just need to multiply it against the mask.r. Cool, now it looks like it's masking. Okay, so this works pretty well. I also added this red background here so that we can easily see what's happening here. And if we use this default sphere, this default ball, we can kind of see the mask working. It's just kind of displaying mostly in the middle and fading out on the edges. Very cool. So what if we wanted to use this mask as a way to reveal this B? Yeah, so one of the ways we can do that is with a step function. And a step looks like this. It's pretty much an on or off. It's either 0 or 1. In other words, it only reveals if x is greater or equal to than x. So what we can do is have a, using this step function, what we can do is have a value where it kind of determines, okay, when do I want to allow the B to be shown? That's usually how I think about it. So let's think of it as reveal. We'll call it a reveal value. It's going to be a float. We make sure it's declared here. And a step function will work like this. We'll see reveal amount. What we want is the mask value to be first and the reveal value to be second, right? Because we are testing against the reveal value. This way, whenever the mask is, let's say, very dark, that's where the texture will start to reveal. And as it gets to white, as reveal value gets to white, it shows the full amount of the texture. So it looks something like this. Right, so it starts off from the black, which is on the outer edges. And then as it goes white, it'll reveal this much, right? Of course, you can inverse it by flipping these two. But this works well with a texture that's more clouded-like. So, starting from 0, it starts where the blacks are. And as it goes higher and higher, it reveals out the white. That's how this works. So now this works, but you know this value here is a little bit harsh. It's either on or off, right? There's no feathering. There's no smoothness between the two. So what if we wanted to add that? So let's go ahead and add a feathered value that we can tune. just going to add it onto here. So how feathering works, what we need is something called smooth step. All right, smooth step is, as it says here, as it states right here, smoothly interpolate between two input values based on the third. Our third value is the reveal amount, and what we need are two input values. So I always think of it as, you know, this is the lower value, this is the upper value, right? So let's do smooth step here. If I save this off, there should be no changes. Yeah, despite having a feathered amount, there should be no changes. It's not until we add the feathered amount, or in this case, subtract. So what I want is the bottom end to be minus feather, and the top end to be plus feather. Right, like so. Save that off, and there you go. That is our feathered amount. So now when we do our reveal to zero and up to one, it should work. Okay, so this works, but a lot of people sometimes want to see a bit of color in between. I mean, this is an erosion effect, and having color in between here is quite a common effect. I guess it's just called erosion with color. So how do we do that? Well, smooth step was kind of the precursor to it, but in order to actually implement it, we don't actually need smooth step. Instead, we need two normal step functions, upper range and a lower range. So let's go ahead and do that. Reveal amount, and oh, here I'm going to show one, and I'm going to display the reveal amount. So let's do this, where it's float reveal amount is equal to, we're going to go bring it back to what we had before, which is a step of the mask R, followed by our reveal value. Here I'm going to return the reveal amount in as a white, and I'm also just going to put one in the alpha. Cool, so that is our reveal amount. So what we need is a top and bottom. So let's go ahead and duplicate this. And we'll call this first one reveal top and reveal bottom. To create a top, what we need to do is add feather to our reveal amount and subtract it from our bottom amount. So let's quickly display the top. We'll see this. We should see more when it's the top and less when it's the bottom. Okay. So in order to get the difference, the white that's in between, we'll call it this is more of the space between the two reveals. So we'll call it difference, reveal difference. It's equal to top minus bottom. All right, so let's show the reveal difference, and we get this white line. Okay, now in order for us to have an erosion color, we need to multiply a color against this reveal difference. So let's quickly add a color up here. We'll call it erode color. It's gonna be type color, and I'm gonna default it to white. All right, so we have our erode color. Let's just check there's no errors. Great. So the first thing we wanna do is we want to lerp. Wherever it is black, we want it to show our color, or sorry, our image, so our cull. And wherever it's white, we want to show the color. So our final color, it will be a float 3 is equal to lerp. And we're lerping between cull.rgb. So wherever it's black, it's going to show the B. And wherever it is white, we want it to show our color, which is erode color, which is probably defaulted to white anyway, but that's okay. we wanted to lerp this by the erode difference or the reveal difference. Let's put a final color here and comment this out, see what it looks like. Cool, and our erode color can be any color. Let's just set it to green for now. Our feather still works as a thickness. It can go inverted, we can fix that, but I'll just leave it for now. And usually something kind of thin looks pretty good. And we also need to make sure our reveal, our alpha, is still set. And what we want to do is make sure we cut off from the top end, not from the bottom end. If we cut off from the bottom end, we actually lose the color as well, right? So to quickly demonstrate, cutting from the bottom end, we'll lose the color. But if we cut off from the top end, it's after the color, right? So yeah, that's how you get an erode with color. And you can change this into multiple things. You can have multiple colors. You can lerp between this small range based on maybe feathering. You can, because this is now, it's almost like its own mask, right? Erode color against this reveal difference. You can kind of put whatever you want here, an image, etc., right? So. Yeah, so I just quickly added this animation, reveal anim, instead of us driving it from this value. But yeah, that is it for this particular video. I mean, you can have artists drive this value. You can use it as a game effect, destroying characters. There's actually many ways you can use this effect. So hope you guys learned something. And that's all for me. If you like what you see, like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.